So now today class, we are going to discussing about the structure of heart. The human heart is present between the two lungs of thoracic cavity, is called mediastinum. So the heart, the size of the heart is fist of an individual, and then the heart is pear shaped or cone shaped structure. The weight of the heart is nearly 300 grams of the total weight of the body. So when we discuss about the structure of heart, heart consists atria, ventricles and blood vessels. So in this, the first part is atria. Atria are upper chambers of the heart. Total four chambers are there in the heart. Atria are two in number. The one right atria and second one is left atrium. So atria are upper chambers of the body, and they receive blood from the body parts. Means right atria receives deoxygenated or impure blood from the body part except lungs. So via caval veins, vena cava, the largest veins are called vena cava. So here the pre-caval veins, means a pair of pre-caval veins, receives deoxygenated blood from the anterior parts of the body and pumps into the right atrium. And then post-caval vein or post-vena cava, it receives impure blood from the posterior parts of the body and pumps into the right atria. And then when we discuss about the left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the lungs through a pair of pulmonary veins. In generally, they receive deoxygenated blood to the heart, but here pulmonary vein is different. So it receives, a pair of pulmonary veins receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and releases into the left atrium. Then the right atria and the left atria both are separated by the interatrial septum. Then atria and ventricles are separated by a transverse septum called atrioventricular septum. Now here the right atrium opens into the right ventricle through the aperture called right atrioventricular aperture. This right atrioventricular aperture is guarded by tricuspid wall. And then left atrium, it is separated from left atrium by, it opens into the left ventricle through left atrioventricular aperture, which is guarded by bicuspid or mitral wall. So this is about the upper chambers. Right atria receives impure blood from the body parts. Left atria receives pure blood or oxygenated blood from the lungs. Okay, so this is about the atria. And then go for the ventricles. Ventricles are the lower chambers. So the right ventricle, and these are called pumping chambers. They pump the blood to different parts of the body. Here, right ventricle, so it pumps the blood to lungs for oxygenation, where it receives the impure blood from the right atria. Means from the body parts, where it enters into the right atria, from there it enters into the right ventricle. From here, it enters into the lungs through pulmonary artery. So for oxygenation. Okay, so the opening of the pulmonary artery, it is guarded by three pairs of semilunar walls. Okay, so this is about the right ventricle. And then go for the left ventricle. Left ventricle has got oxygenated blood from the left atrium, and it pumps the oxygenated blood to the body parts for their metabolic activities through systemic artery. The largest systemic artery, the largest artery is called systemic artery, and it is called aorta. What is that? Aorta. So this systemic aorta, it gives so many branches, the anterior part of the body as well as posterior part of the body. They gives, they supplies blood to the concerned body parts. So this is about the structure of heart, in the four chambers of the heart. And here the two ventricles are separated by interventricular septum. Interventricular septum. Then go further. What is that? Blood vessels. What are the blood vessels are there in the heart structure? So what is their function? Here see veins, arteries and veins. And we discuss about the arteries. The largest artery is called as aorta. We have discussed here the systemic aorta. It supplies oxygenated blood from the left ventricle to the body parts. This is about the largest aorta, that is the systemic aorta. And here see the pulmonary artery. So this pulmonary artery, pair of pulmonary arteries, they supplies blood to the lungs for oxygenation. So this is the difference between the systemic artery and pulmonary artery. Systemic artery supplies oxygenated blood to the body parts. Pulmonary artery, it supplies deoxygenated blood to the lungs for the oxygenation from the right ventricle. This is about the systemic aorta and the pulmonary aorta. Then go for the vena cava. Means when we see the vena cava, what about the vena cava? Here a pair of pre-caval veins or anterior vena cava. Pre-caval veins or anterior vena cava, they receive blood from the anterior parts of the body from both the sides and opens into the right atrium of the heart. And one post-caval vein or posterior vena cava, it receives blood from the posterior parts of the body and pumps into the right atrium. So this is about the vena cava, systemic vena cava. And when we see the pulmonary veins also there, what is the difference between the systemic vena cava and pulmonary vena cava? Systemic vena cava, they receives deoxygenated blood from the body parts and pumps into the right atrium. So that is about the thing, except from the lungs. So here pulmonary vena cava, a pair of pulmonary vena cava, so they receive oxygenated blood from the lungs. They receive oxygenated blood from the lungs and opens into the left atria individually. So means pulmonary vena cava, they receive oxygenated blood from the lungs. Systemic vena cava, they receive deoxygenated blood from the body parts. This is the major difference between the systemic vena cava and the pulmonary vena cava. And we discuss about the walls. What are the walls of there in the internal structure of the heart? Here see tricuspid wall and bicuspid wall. What is the function of tricuspid wall? This tricuspid wall, it is present, it guards the right atrioventricular aperture. What is the function of the tricuspid wall? During the ventricular contraction. So during the ventricular contraction, this ventricular contraction takes place from the posterior end to anterior end of the ventricles. When the blood pumps anteriorly, so to prevent the backflow of blood. So when the blood pumps like this, the blood may be tries to enter into the right atria. So to prevent this right atrioventricular aperture closes the tricuspid wall, closes the right atrioventricular aperture, then the blood enters into the, what is that, pulmonary artery and pumps into the lungs. So whereas here also, so to prevent the backflow of blood from right left ventricle to left atria, so this bicuspid wall closes the, what is that, left atrioventricular aperture, then the blood enters into the systemic artery and supplies to the body parts. So this is about the thing. So, and what about the function of the semilunar walls? During the relaxation of the heart, when the ventricles are relaxed, the blood may be charged reversed from the arteries to the ventricles. To prevent this, these semilunar walls are closed. Then the backflow of blood will be prevented and it should be moves in forward direction. This is about the total structure of heart. Thank you.